All aboard!
This is Pelon and Chubby with a special on-location recording. Not your normal podcast, because we're at the Intensity Athletic Sports Complex. We're here to raise funds for the Surge H5 Extreme Cheer Team. So we talk to some parents, and we interview Esther Ku, Chad and Cory from the Smash Brothers, and Sigmund Valentine of the LOL crew. This is how we do Pelon and Chubby, on-site location. It's just Pelon and Chubby holding it down. Interviews with parents, interviews with the host and the cast of the show. Check us out. It's the Pelon and Chubby Show with your hosts Rich Salas and Guy Murray, talking about comedy and everything that crosses their mind. It's the Pelon and Chubby Show.
Can't stay quiet on the set, but we're live. Pelon and Chubby, special edition on the set.
We're good?
And we're live.
Hello and welcome to another episode of the Pelon and Chubby. Hold on, wait a minute.
Hold up.
This is a special episode of the Pelon and Chubby. Thanks for joining us all the way across the world.
Right.
We appreciate you being here. This is a special event for Intensity Athletics Cheer. These are like a professional competitive cheer, and they go around and they go out and work their hardest and darndest to make their parents proud and make everybody proud and win awards and do all that stuff. But tonight, it's comedy night.
It's comedy
night. Chad and Cory, the Smash Brothers, are here with Esther Ku.
What's in the house?
And all brought to you by Valentine and the LOL crew. Bringing it like they always do, 300-400 deep, here to enjoy comedy. There's nothing better than laughing out there and forgetting about the day-to-day and all the troubles and the fires and all the stuff going on. You're just coming out tonight to get a little laugh on.
Get your laugh on.
And I know I like these people because they got 805 pouring out.
Right out the tap.
Out of the tap from the trailer, the horse trailer. Hey, that's the perfect horse trailer. It doesn't carry horses. It carries booze.
Yes, sir.
I love it. 805 pouring out. I couldn't be happier. Thank you very much. But we're all doing this for a good cause. This is all going to help this group, the Intensity Athletics, and raise money for them. All the drinks, they got the barbecue going on outside, and they got a famous DJ in there spinning on the ones and twos, old school style. Got
old
videos
school,
going
for real.
And that's why you can't hear on the background, you hear the music in the background. It's going to be a little bit of a battle pay tonight, but it's still going to be fun. We're going to have some fun tonight.
We're going to get it in right now. I'm telling you, I got a lot of people popping in. Hey, April Hall, what's up going on? Amy Hackett, what's up? Amanda Vuyer,
Amy Medina.
Hey, Medina's in the house.
Hey, thanks
Nielsen's
for joining. It's
house.
Not going to be like the normal podcast. It's she every Wednesday, Pelon and Chubby Show. Now, we're out here in beautiful Murrietta, California. We're out here going to watch some comedy tonight. I don't know if you've ever seen Smash Brothers, but if you get a chance after you watch us, go online and check them out. Cory and Chad, they're twins. They come hard, huh, guys?
They tear it up, man. And you've seen them on Comedy Central. You've seen them on you can find them everywhere. You know what I'm saying? Those guys are pretty hot.
Also, Guy had the Guy was moonlighting from the Pelon and Chubby Show and went out and did the audio recording for Esther Ku down somewhere in San Diego. So he had the privilege of seeing her a few times in a row. And so he has... what do you got to say? Hopefully we can interview her later.
Yeah, hopefully we'll get her on the mic. And she's an amazing comic, too. You know, you were worried about, like, saying something racist.
Uh-huh.
Right off the top, she'll go straight to the cup. She don't play.
She'll just
lay it on you.
Right, which is fine. I mean, keep it real. You know, everybody gets so nervous all the time about everything. But keep it real, you know. That's what it's all about. I want to try and get Valentine over here since together with Intensity, have put together this show tonight. So I kind of want him to get over here and tell people all about it. The festivities will start in about an hour. But, you know, black folks involved, sometimes it might be a little later.
A little
later
bit later, a little bit slower, a little bit later. And it's says Murrietta, so you got to get past that border check.
Right.
You got to get past that 703 merge. You got to get past the 79 North, baby. You got to
Most of these folks, I believe, live out here.
I think they're locals. But there's a barbecue truck outside, too, so that's going to slow things up for us a little bit.
Barbecue is good. It's going to be all good.
It's going to be
we
great.
We just got to get Valentine over here. And then I wanted to get the lady from Intensity.
From Intensity Athletics.
I don't know where she went, but she was over here.
Oh, there she is at the door. But that's okay. You know, they got people coming in. And
yeah, maybe we can
It's a family affair.
Yeah.
Hugs and high fives going on around
here.
That's
kind of cool. I don't know if you had a chance. They didn't have a chance to see the actual venue inside, but it's nice. Looks like it's going to hold about 300-400 people pretty easy.
Yeah,
that's kind of cool.
I'll probably walk out the live here so you guys can see that feed and go to the event page itself. It's where this is tagged. This is where this is broadcasting from. And yes, this is going to be good. It's a good thing.
Yeah, it looks like there's going to be a ton of people here supporting a good cause.
What's up,
it's important
Sparrow?
To get kids. Hey, see if we can get somebody
get
Val.
Okay.
And so they can talk about this event. But I think it's important, whether it's like a cheer or whether it's dance or whether it's football, soccer clubs, baseball, whatever. It's important to get your kids involved in stuff that is fun, exercising, healthy. You know, they're not getting into trouble. They're not out hanging out with the wrong people. They're doing something constructive.
All right, I'm gonna go mobile real quick. You keep that feed going there.
So I mean, that's what I appreciate about stuff like this, that it gets kids involved in the community. It gets kids learning something exciting like cheer. I'll tell you, if you've never seen competitive cheer, it's no joke. If you watch like on ESPN, college stuff, I mean these people they are in shape. They are intense. So it's no joke. It's like this is a true sport, not like you see maybe on the sidelines at football games. But it's no knock against them, you know. But it's just this is a different form. It's the name of the club, Intensity. It is intense. You know, they get into this stuff. They practice a lot. But it not only is it healthy for them, getting out there and exercising, but it keeps them, like I said, from hanging around with the wrong people. It keeps them involved. Kids, any kind of downtime that they have, there are a lot of times they're going to get in trouble. And not to say that these kids are going to get in trouble, but it's only natural. That's the way it is. That's the way it goes. So I don't know if you guys had a chance to go and rewatch Wednesday's episode of the Pelon and Chubby Show. It was pretty good. I felt good about it. I thought I was excited about it. It was a good show, I thought. But you know, give me some feedback. Send me some little notes on Facebook here and tell me what you guys thought. But grab yourself a drink. We're going to be here for a minute. We'll probably be broadcasting for about an hour. We're trying to get Valentine, the producer of the show, and then somebody from Intensity. And then as the comics show up, we're going to try and get them on and have them talk about how they started in comedy. You know, this is a comedy thing, so it has to do with our show is involved with comedy. So all of us have that kind of common denominator, that tie doing comedy. So that's why we're out here, because Valentine is producing this comedy show, and we're here to support him. Give him as much exposure as possible about his group, all the stuff that he's working with. And I believe his daughters are involved in this Intensity cheer club. So it's it all kind of ties in together like that. Valentine's my business partner in a few things. 805, people. So we're all... we all get together on a lot of different things that we're involved in. And you'll see more and hear more later on, but that's how the tie comes in. That's how we all know each other. That's why we support one another in events like this. So what's everybody doing on a beautiful Saturday night out there? It's a little chilly out here. Murrietta's probably going to get in the mid to high 40s. This is a lot like Tracy in the sense that it's in the valley. So it gets a little cold. And then in the summertime, 115 is definitely possible. They hit it often. So should be cool. Anyway, if anybody's out in this way, in the Murrietta way, and they want to get their kids involved in a cheer group like this, tumbling training facility for boys and girls, the phone number here is 951-696-2433. I hear some in the background. Guy?
What's up? You hear it?
I don't know. Like our show in the background?
Turn off your mic.
I don't have it on here. So anyway, I'm going to give out the numbers and all that so you can contact these folks if you want to. I don't even know if it's like open enrollment.
I really don't know.
We just got here kind of. So
they look like they wanted to put us on the team.
Yeah, so we don't know.
I'll go cheer.
We really don't know how this whole thing works.
I'll be working on it. I mean, all I know is I got a wristband. I'm legit. Tickets are being at the door. Tickets are buying. People are buying at the door. People are buying barbecue right outside the door.
Hey, why I don't have the video?
We're going live. We're live. What's up, Andrea? Michael? Ooh, look at that.
How come I don't have it, dude?
I don't know. Are you doing? Yeah, you went to your tag. There you are.
There it is.
Turn your audio down.
Is it down?
Yeah.
It's down.
It's all good.
Amy Hudson. What's up? So what did they say about getting somebody from their joint?
I could not find the one mom. She's actually selling tickets right at the door. I told her that she can come in a minute.
Where's Valentine?
He's on the inside. On the inside looking out. I got people up here, too, you know. And y'all should be coming down. Y'all should be coming down.
Yeah, you still have time. I figure it's going to start probably about 8 o'clock. So you got plenty of time. Anyway, I wanted to go over this real quick. They'll probably do it again, but it's Intensity Athletics. This is a comedy show to promote and make money for, fundraise for Intensity Athletics. Tumbling and training facility for boys and girls. Call 951-696-2433. It is at 38444 Sky Canyon Drive, Suite 140 in Murrietta, California, 92563. And the website is www.intensityathletics.net. Intensityathletics.net. If you want to get a hold of them, check them out online. You can call them. I need somebody to come over. Is it gymnastics? Is it cheer? I mean, what?
It's competitive cheering. I'm going to get
but
that mom.
But here it looks like it says tumbling and training facility.
Well, I think Intensity does it all, but the
She's part of it. Are you part of the, you do this?
Are you one of the?
Huh? No? What are you doing here? I need somebody from. Is there any of the people that are like members or anything? Is there any?
Intensity Athletics.
Any members here? You know about it, right?
We're all parents.
Okay, perfect. All right. All right, perfect. Where's the mic at?
Mic's right there.
Come on in. Here, come in. Jump in.
I need a drink.
So, what's your name?
Chris.
All right, Chris. I'm Pelon. This is Chubby. We're the Pelon and Chubby Show. We have a podcast that we do weekly, and this week we're here at Intensity Athletics to help promote, help make, give awareness to get our kids involved in athletics, whatever kind of athletics it is, and getting them down here. Tonight's a comedy show put on by you guys and by Valentine, the LOL crew. And you guys set up a website, I believe. And it's comedy and athletics, I believe. Right, we'll give you all the information later on. I read out all this, but let's get down to it. You're a parent here, right?
Yes.
Okay, how many kids do you have that...
I had three.
Three.
Two boys and one girl.
And they're all involved in this?
Yes.
All right, now, clear it up for us. We're new at this. Intensity athletics is gymnastics, because it says here...
It's a competitive cheer gym that also does tumbling training and technique training.
So basically the basics of competitive cheer is probably a lot of the tumbling and, right? So
that
gives you the basics, right? So you got three kids involved, two boys.
Two boys and one girl.
Which for a lot of people, it's not super common to have boys in cheer.
Right.
But competitive cheer is different. I was explaining earlier, like when you go to a football game, no knock on the girls that are on the sideline during the football game. You know, they're doing their thing, cheering for their school, showing it. But it is a big difference from competitive
they're
cheer.
They don't do a lot of dangerous stunts. They don't, and they may in their competition teams, I'm not really sure.
Right.
For the most part, it's more of a team support as opposed to a team sport. So it's a team support for the rah-rah ones. And for these guys, they're competing against other gyms, so it's more of a team sport.
So I was kind of explaining earlier how it's so great, I don't care what sport it is, to get your kids involved in something like this.
Absolutely.
And not only for health reasons, but it keeps them busy. When kids have downtime and they're not busy, they get into stuff. No matter what it is, they get into stuff. It could be just sitting home and grubbing.
Exactly.
For whatever, sitting on the video games all day. So it's cool to get them out. I mean, how do you see a change in your kids since they first started?
100%. So as far as their skill levels, through the roof, 10 times better than when they started.
Right.
As far as any of the other... kind of hard to explain, you know.
Well, if it's anything like for me, I played football and baseball. Being on a team, it kind of taught me how to work together with others and prepare me for later on in life.
Absolutely.
You know, so.
And they learn leadership skills. They learn how to work as a team, you know, form bonds with different groups of kids that, you know, you would think would never hang out in the same spot.
Plus, there's a lot of trust involved. I mean, I've seen some of the where they throw them up in the air and they do flips, and then they got to catch them. You know, you got to trust that your people are going
to
be there and catch you.
You have to.
You know, and that they're capable of doing it.
That's where the teamwork comes in.
Yeah,
sure.
So that's cool. Now, does it break the bank or is it affordable?
It's pretty. With three of them, it gets very expensive.
Right, right.
All right.
But you know, I always tell our friends and everything. I go, I would rather spend the money and have my kids involved with a community like this where I don't have to worry about them taking drugs or hanging out with the wrong kids or getting in fights or doing any of that partying. You know, for me, it doesn't matter how much it costs. It's worth it.
Yeah, and you know what? That's
their life skills they get from it.
That's the important thing, man. If somehow you can make it work, it's better than going out and spending money in the bar every week.
It's better,
you know,
to pay for
smoking.
Pay to get them out of jail. You know?
Yeah. So it's good, you know, and I give it up to you, you know, for getting them involved. You know, those are the things that are, like we talk about core values and stuff that are going to make, I'm not going to use the quote of some dude we know, but make America great again. so it'll definitely work. Yes. I saw Valentine out here in his pimp suit.
Oh, he got all pretty up.
Did he go back and hide?
Have
you seen any of the guys performing tonight before?
I Googled the Smash Brothers.
Okay,
so it looks like
put your seatbelt on.
Looks like it's gonna be a great show.
They're intense.
Exactly.
All right, we'll get all liquored up.
Enjoy. Thank you.
The show's always funnier when you've had a few cocktails.
I appreciate you guys.
And if you see a pimp in there, tell him to come on out. Thanks, bro. So there's a nice interview with one of the parents. Very, very cool, you know. It takes, you know, we give it up to these kids for going out and doing this stuff and this group, this intensity athletics for being here for these kids, but you got to give it up to the parents too, because the parents
got to show up.
Hey, and they got to go to work.
Yep.
And they got to fork over that money. They might want to buy something special, maybe a little lingerie for the wife or something. But now, they got to go and spend it for the kids on their training for life.
Definitely.
So you
got
to give it up to them for doing something like that, you know, and making it possible, you know. So that's good. That is very, very cool. Looking for Valentine guy. Talk to these people. Give them the numbers again. I'm going to see if I can find them.
So once again, we're downtown right here at the Intensity Athletics. It's the tumbling training facility for boys and girls, as we just talked to one of the parents here. And definitely get the kids involved. We have their phone number is 951-696-2433. They have a new website. It's Athletics for Funny. And we got a address there at 38444 Sky Canyon Drive, Suite 140 in Murrietta, California, 92563.
Check. So the plan. Oh, the plan is to. Whoa! Who's that?
That's something backing up.
Hey, the plan is to get Valentine out here and have him talk about all this, and then get the comics out here and talking. But.
Yeah, it looks like we're running a bit of...
Hey, and stuff like this, it's a little hard...
the logistics and trying to lasso everybody and get everybody round up.
We don't have a producer, per se.
This is flyby. This is a lot of chiefs and a lot of engines.
A lot of backing up going on. Nice. Alright. Turn that shit out.
That's the tour bus.
Hmm?
That's the tour bus.
Is it?
Looks like a bus.
Who's big enough to have a tour bus? Whatever.
Pelon and Chubby is one
day.
Yeah,
we are.
We're going to be big enough to have our own.
And the bus is coming pretty quick here. For sure. So,
tonight performer, we've got...
You got any people coming out tonight?
The Smash Brothers are performing. Esther Ku is performing.
Where are you on there?
I'm broadcasting from the actual event page. And so their event page. And so everybody that's in the LOL crew, all 285 people, plus my people are tagged, Elijah Howard, Michael Nielsen, thanks for hanging out. Pecos. And we're here. We're live.
Hey, the music's great. It's just unfortunate that it is
it's a gymnasium, so this is
cock blocking our show. Hey, it's an adult night. We can say that.
We can say that.
It's 18 and up tonight. The show, trust me, if you've never seen these guys before, yeah.
Yeah, about that. Yeah, this is gonna be a good one.
It's gonna be out there, you know, a little loud.
No worries though. No worries. This is gonna be good. It's gonna be a good night for talking about comedy. I have to definitely.
So if you're out in the area, come on down. You got until 8 o'clock to come through. Tickets are on sale at the door. There he is. Are on sale at the door. The drinks are available. They got a full bar. Like I said, they got 805 pouring. I love that. I ain't gonna lie. So without further ado.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Ado, baby, you
let
know
me,
what it is.
Let me give proper introduction.
Please do.
This young man is a... first of all, a good friend of ours.
Yes, most
he
definitely.
Is a friend of the Pelon and Chubby Show.
Yep.
He is an entrepreneur. He is making things happy with My Fat Belly Gotta Go. And just to make the announcement, I waited till tonight to make the announcement to the Pelon and Chubby group, to everybody out there that's listening. I have been on the product My Fat Belly Gotta Go, thanks to this man here, Valentine, and I've been on it for a week. And have lost over 6 pounds.
Damn.
Now the weight is not.
That's a lot of back fat off your ass.
Yeah, that is.
Can I cuss on this show?
Yes, sir. This is an adult show. Earmuffs for the kids. Look, but it's not so much the weight. I feel great, man.
Yeah,
it gives me energy. I feel a lot of the toxins leaving my body already, and it's only been a week. I can't imagine after 30, 60, and 90 days,
yep,
the effect it's going to have on me. And I'm not one of those people that believe in just anything, because actually I doubt most products that are out there, because most of them are gimmicks.
Yes.
And it wasn't anything necessarily that Valentine said. He just got me to do it and asked me if I was going to do it religiously.
Yeah, you have to do it religiously.
And I have been. So like I said, without further ado, the man behind many things, but tonight he's the one that has teamed up with Intensity Athletics for this LOL production. This is Valentine and the LOL crew here in beautiful Murrietta, California, with the headliners Chad and Cory, Esther Ku, making an appearance.
Yes.
It is going to be a show off the hook, and it's designed to raise money for Intensity Athletics. But you can explain a little better what this thing means, how you put it together, and what you expect for tonight.
Okay, so check this out. My name is Sigmund Valentine. Pleasure to meet all y'all. Boom, you rocking with the best. So here it is. So in reference to the My Fat Belly Gotta Go Party, the My Fat Belly Gotta Go Party is specifically designed for people who have lost hope, for those who have been trying everything and nothing worked. The greatest piece of it all is me, because I've lost 50 pounds in 5 months back in 2015. It's 2018, and I'm still a little bit more sexy. You know what I mean? I got a little bit more back fat off my ass. The fat belly's gone, and guess what? The performance in every other way. And when I say performance, I don't play football, so you know I'm performing elsewhere. Hey, it's working out beautifully. It's working out beautifully. So tonight, I stopped doing stand-up comedy because the My Fat Belly Gotta Go program was forced upon me, because it was me and I helped my wife. My wife has lost like 50 pounds herself and kept it off. She's healthy. All of the ailments that she had in reference to her thyroid and knee problems and all that, that's gone. At the same time, I was helping my mother, my sister, and then their friends, and then their friends, and then their friends, and then boom. I had no other choice but to start a company. Me and my awesome brother that's here tonight. Actually, we're all hosting this show tonight to raise money for Intensity.
Hey, so the actual website isn't live yet, right?
MyFatBellyGottaGo.com is live.
Okay, perfect.
SuperfoodWeightLoss.com is live.
Which is that's the actual company name.
Exactly. SuperfoodWeightLoss.com. That's live. SuperfoodWeightLoss.com is live. Now what we created is the My Fat Belly Gotta Go Party, because there's zero representation for the fat bellies of America. So guess what? You have the Democratic Party, the Republican Party, the Independent Party, and you have the My Fat Belly Gotta Go Party. Guess what? It is I who represent the fat bellies of America.
Hey, I'll tell you what. It's no joke, man. This thing, they are on the cusp of something big here, something that's gonna take over, revolutionize the world here.
Yes, sir.
This is gonna eliminate all of the sickness. That's a couple of beers in me. Hey, but it's gonna, a lot of these people out there go to the doctor, complain about all these ailments. All they suffer from is fat, to tell you the truth.
Well,
you eliminate that fat.
Let me jump in. And here's another thing. You got so many men over 40 that can't get hung. Why? They're trying to take all these damn pills, but guess what? If you change the way you eat and get your ass out there and be active, your dick gonna get hard.
That's right.
So guess what?
You need that.
I was watching the Hims commercial the other night.
For Hims.
And they said the HIMs, it was about 3 o'clock in the morning, I couldn't sleep. And, you know, because I'm going a little ball in the back. When you look at me in the front, I look like I'm 35. When I start walking away from your ass, I look like I'm 65. I'm like, hey, this motherfucker fooled me.
Hey, hopefully nobody's looking at you from the back.
Hey, they looking at me from the back because I got a nice ass too.
Got to go.
Check that out.
They
Rick,
go.
Stop hating.
Hey,
man.
Somebody looking at you from the back with his hands on your shoulders.
No. She. And her name is Miss Valentine.
That's right. Hey, but I'll tell you what, I appreciate, you know what? Hey, I appreciate your company. I appreciate you for what you guys are doing.
Yes, sir.
Because when you ride with me in the car now, you don't spill over into my seat no more.
Exactly. For real, dude. Not exaggerating. I was 290 pounds, almost 300 pounds, pre-diabetic, high blood pressure, high cholesterol, everything high except for energy. But I was still sexy and chocolatey, though.
Hey, so your company believes so much in being involved in all kinds of different things. Now, what is the direct correlation between superfood, My Fat Belly Gotta Go, and Intensity Athletics?
Well, there's really no connection because we're not promoting the business or the company here. Our main objective is just to raise money for Intensity Athletics.
Why?
Well, because my daughter attends this gym.
Right.
My brother's daughter, their kids attend this gym. So we know that they're about to go to Hawaii. So they have different fundraisers where they make like $50 or $100 from selling nuts and candy and all that. And then they were like, hey, you put on a lot of big shows. What do you think about helping us put on a comedy show? I'm like, let's get it. Let's do it. Yeah. So that's what this is all about.
Let's get it in.
Plus, you know what? It goes to show you, like, you getting involved in this is super important, man, because not only is it getting your body and mind right with the products
that... Yeah, Michael, your ass might be fat. Let's see what's happening.
Hey, with the products that you guys are introducing, plus physical activity doesn't hurt.
Well,
you know?
Let me share something with you. So what we're developing now, because we own a software company based out of India, and what's happening now is you're going to join the My Fat Belly Gotta Go party for free. We're going to take you through a series of videos, and those videos are going to teach you things that you never knew. And then we're going to introduce the product to you and give it to you at a discount as long as you continue to watch the videos that's going to help you develop a new lifestyle. Because weight loss has much less to do with working out and starving yourself and more to do with putting nutrition into your body. Studies have shown that people who have provided nutrition to their body and drank water, drank the appropriate amount of water, and lived an active lifestyle lives for a very, very, very long time.
That's what's up, right there.
Hey, so I know you got a really busy night tonight. You got to get back to what you got going on. We're going to try and get somebody, if you can help us out with, from Intensity Athletics to talk about the program here.
Yes, sir.
And then we want to try and get whatever comics that are here to come and say what's up.
They'll be here in a little bit.
All right, so and then you got more stuff to do, but we're going to try and put the websites for Superfoods, the website for My Fat Belly Gotta Go, and for Intensity on the website.
Yes, sir.
So people can go after the show and they can check it out and get as much information. But believe me, believe Valentine when we tell you that this product is for real. It's going to cure your ailments that you got, and it's going to make you look good again.
Make you look good and make you perform, boy.
Forget making America great again. Make you look
make
good
you
again.
Great again. Make you look great again.
All right, brother. Hey.
The website is myfatbelly.com.
Gottago.com. That's gotta, G-O-T-T-A.
And
we're
then,
putting some Ebonics up in there.
And then Superfoods.
Superfoodweightloss.com.
All right. And then IntensityAthletics.net.
Yeah, IntensityAthletics.net.
All right, so help me out. Send the comics over when they get a chance to come over.
I got that cut.
And have a good show tonight,
though.
Well,
what are you supposed to be doing?
That's a pop.
Spit.
So the
pop. No, that, it's stopping a whole lot of spit because I'm looking at it for you. If it wasn't for that, that whole thing would be covered with spit.
It'd be dripping. Oh, hey, real quick. Just to let you know, folks, look right here. This will be the new show, podcast that's coming out.
Yeah.
Tell them what it is. Yeah.
We're coming out with a new show, and it's going to be called Yeah, I Said It.
And
or it's going to be You Motherfucking Right, I Said It.
So you go.
I like that better. Hey, we need to do a contest. Y'all let us know which one is best. Yeah, I Said It, or motherfucking Said It.
Hey, so we're going to be, it'll be the new podcast coming out.
Yes.
Valentine and myself.
Yes.
And it's going to be rocking.
Oh, it's going to be crazy.
Out.
You already know.
Woo!
All right, thank y'all for having me on.
All right. Is that Ricky Johnson?
No.
It's not Ricky Johnson. That's Ricky Bell. Oh, my goodness.
All right, so, hey, you got it firsthand from the man that put all this together and makes this thing go. He is in charge of putting the show together. He also is got the My Fat Belly Gotta Go. He's got the whole thing going. So if you're in the Murrietta area and you know Valentine, you know Chubby, or you know me, or you know anybody that's involved in this, come on down, check out a comedy show. You actually have some very talented comics that are going to be performing tonight. So it's going to a good cause. It's a good Saturday night out. It's a fun night. So come on down, check it out. I think you'll like it.
You'll love it.
I know you'll like it.
Oh, yeah. Doing what we do best.
I'm going to do another roll around the building real quick, see if I see any other famous people. We got...
I may be able to get a parent to come in again.
Yeah, we got one coming on the way.
And talk.
Get live, talk to another parent.
We need somebody from the cheer group management type to come and talk about the athletic group. And then as the comics come in, hopefully we can get a comic to come over and say what's up. But if you're just tuning in, this is a special episode on remote
in
Murrietta, California.
Don't play.
We are here at the Valentine and LOL Crew comedy show fundraiser for Intensity Athletics.
And the Cheer Squad H5.
It'll be, it's going to be a really, really cool show, man. But we're trying to get some interviews set over here. I need another drink in a minute.
That DJ's live, man. I like that.
Hey, the DJ is from some movie.
That's DJ Pooh?
I don't know. He's from a movie.
I'm going to go find out where he's from.
Like an old school movie, like Friday or something.
Okay.
The DJ from Friday?
Okay.
I think that's him.
Huh. We're going to check that out.
Career's on fire. It's all good. There she is.
Come on down. Come on down.
Get in the seat here. Come on.
What's up?
All right, so for lack of preparation getting here in time, we know that you are a representative of Intensity Athletics. Are you the founder?
No,
what is your role?
I'm a team mom.
You're
Surge.
A team mom.
Which team?
Surge.
Surge.
All right, what's
the team that this has been?
H5? Surge. Right.
Surge 5, level 5.
5, okay, Surge
level
5.
Which
level
is part 5. Of Intensity Athletics?
Yes.
All right,
this
so.
Is our highest level we have.
All right, there. So you guys got the competitive cheer team. Here, from what I'm understanding, you do tumbling and learning stuff here, and then it graduates up into higher levels until the level that you represent,
yes.
Which is the competitive highest level of cheer.
No, the highest level is 6.
Oh, 6, but
yet.
You're
the,
almost there. All right, so what is your name?
Wendy.
And you are a team mom, which means you're in charge of keeping
charge
everybody
of,
sane
that's right,
in
I'm
the
in
group.
I'm in charge of our team.
Right.
I'm in charge
She's
of them.
In charge of kids.
I'm in charge of keeping them sane and making their parents' jobs easy.
Right. And how many kids do you have in the
Our team has 12
program?
Kids.
Well, how many?
12 in our kid. In our
12
team
kids?
Only.
And how many of them are yours?
One.
All right. Cool. We were talking to one of the dads earlier.
They're all your kids.
And
they're all your kids.
He has two boys and one girl in the,
yes.
Oh, in the program, which is cool, you know?
Yeah.
All right, so how are they doing?
Well, tomorrow will be our first comp.
All right, cool. And that is
season.
Where, if people want to come
Long
and
Beach.
Check it out in Long Beach.
Long Beach.
All right, so it's a little drive, but whatever. On a Sunday, you don't have anything going on. You don't like football. You want to go watch some amazing team cheer. Head out to Long Beach and,
right.
and check it out. Is it on the website where it's going to be or anything? Well, you'll find out somehow, some way. But how has it directly impacted your family, your child being involved in competitive cheer?
My kids have always been competitive, period. But it's taught her how to be responsible and dedicated to a sport, and just keeps her out of trouble. Actually.
Yeah, we were talking about that
she
earlier.
She doesn't really have time to be in trouble in anything because she's here
yeah.
or at school.
Plus, it's great for their health.
It's great for their health.
It's great for their health, yes.
So, tonight is for what?
We travel for cheer. We travel far. This year, we've been invited to go to Hawaii.
Oh,
and
nice.
So, what we're trying to do here is raise money so we could help the cost of the family.
So as we talked about earlier, Intensity Athletics, along with Valentine, the LOL crew, and Superfood, everybody has kind of joined together in an effort to raise money to send these youngsters out to Hawaii. Not a bad place to go and hang out and do a little cheer too, huh?
Yeah.
So they're going to go out there and they just are looking for a little push, a little
just
help
a little push,
to get
little
bills paid to get out there.
Comedy shows so raise some money.
If you're out in the Murrietta area, come down. It's not too late. Come down, buy some tickets. Or if you don't want to stay and watch the show, just leave some cash.
That's right.
Walk
we
over
always,
to the door.
We're
just put some
always
money
open
down.
For donations.
Yeah,
there
so,
you, go.
You know, if you think that it's a good thing, or if you were ever involved in it, any of your family was ever involved in any kind of athletics, then you know how important it is to keep the kids involved and keep them going out and do things that they're going to remember for the rest of their lives. So whatever you can do to help support, come down. If you come down and get tickets for the show, you get a couple of drinks, not only are you supporting a great cause, but you're getting a nice night out on a Saturday night and watching some, yeah, you're watching some comedy, some great comics that all have TV credits, and some fine drinks at the bar here, and some good-looking...
Good looking
team mom. All right, so thank you for joining the Pelon and Chubby Show. If you ever want to watch
thank
our
you.
Show, we're here every Wednesday. All you got to do is put into your browser Pelon and Chubby, come out, go onto your computer, go onto whatever, and tune us in. We are at your fingertips always. We are the only one that pulls up on your browser when you type in Pelon and Chubby. So
perfect.
Thank you for joining
thank
us. It's been a pleasure.
Appreciate
and thank you for getting your kids involved
that's
in athletics.
Right. Thank you very
all right,
much.
Cool. We'll see you later.
All right.
So we are going to get the comics here very, very soon. We are waiting. Some guy's going to try and get them over here. But we'll see what's up. We will see what's up. Hopefully you guys are enjoying it. This is a little different. This is a little different than what we're used to doing. Recycle. That's not like the chilled, huh? All right, thank you. That's a great people there helping out at the bar. Like I said, that's a... that is a bar that used to be a horse trailer that has turned into something better, more effective, carrying booze around. That's what everybody needs. I need a trailer like that to follow me around. I can tow it all over the place. A bar with me 24/7. Just in case things get rough, I can just go into the back, into the trailer, and I can have me a cocktail. That's what life's all about, man. Making things more convenient. So it's great to get out here, get out. Usually we're in the Pelon and Chubby studio, but tonight we are out on the road, on the scene in Murrietta. We are at the Valentine and LOL Crew comedy show. We're going to see Chad and Cory, the twins. They are off the hook. If you go online and check them out, they are wild, wild, wild. We're going to see Esther Ku. Valentine's going to get on the, up on stage and say what's up to everybody. I think there's one other comic, but I'm not sure. I should probably know more about it. Thank you. You guys are doing a great job, man. Thank you very much. So we'll see what happens. But I'm hoping Valentine can get me. Valentine, none of the comics here yet? None of the comics here yet?
No.
Still early, huh?
Oh, let me see.
But maybe they can just come over and say what's up for a minute here. But yeah, it's I'm enjoying myself. I'm having 8:05. It'd be nice if the wife could come out. All the babysitters are busy. Chewy, if you're over there watching, sorry you're not here with me, but, you know, it's loud, that's for sure. But Jeff Poppy Gringo, what's up? Burton Ramsey, I see you there. Is that Chris Chapman? Is that Chris Chapman from Redondo Hive? From, I think, St. James? Wow. Amy Hudson, again, still there. I'm thinking. But this is like, hey, folks, if you're tuning in thinking this is going to be the regular Pelon and Chubby show, sorry, but it's going to be kind of in and out a little bit. It's not going to have a whole lot of content until we get the comics here, until we get a bunch of stuff, people maybe from the intensity of things. Tonight is really about making a way for the kids and for supporting the athletics, getting their raising money. So it's more about them than it is about us and the Pelon and Chubby show. So I know you love us, but at the same time, it's for the kids tonight, guy.
So yeah, if you're watching this and you're going in from that, if you're watching this from the event page, there's links in there to the website that we were talking about, but you definitely want to go intensityathletics.net. Make a contribution. They do this for fundraising for their H5 team, the highest level that they have right now, in training, so that they can go to Hawaii. They'd be raising money for every different kind of situation, and this one is going to be a comedy show, and they actually got a Funny for Cheer website going up with this first event, but a bunch of other events coming up real soon, because the LOL Laugh Out Loud crews and like to do productions like that, so they'll definitely be doing a lot more shows. So that Funny for Cheer will be going online as well, featuring the shows that they'll be putting in together between here and Pechanga. So wherever there's a fundraising opportunity to raise money for the cheer team, H5, and Intensity Athletics, definitely will be in the place with that. And we'll get
that DJ's off the hook, man.
Yeah, so he's officially, hey, what's up, Jay Feverman? We're right around the corner, brother. You need to come on down.
I'm messing around with the sound.
Stop it.
I can't fade him out at all, man.
You can't.
Ooh, he's spinning there. He's spinning like he's looking for a job.
Hey, he's really, really rocking, right? Because like, on the Vine and Test, he's a DJ. That's what they do.
Hey, Jay, the Holy Roller's out there watching. What's up, Jay? But we're going to get the comics over here in a minute. Valentine's over there hitting the well. Like I said, look out for the new show. It's coming out. The Pelon and Chubby show is going to keep rocking harder than it has been. We are getting the audio and video dialed in. The camera's coming in. If anybody's got any hookup on cameras, as far as the price goes, we have a good idea of what we want. We just need a good deal from somebody on it. If any of the camera companies are looking for sponsorship, we would love that. By all means, we would love it. We're going to get all that together. So we'll have the Pelon and Chubby show coming out of the Pelon and Chubby studio. And then we're also going to have the, with Sigmund Valentine and Rick Salas and the new podcast coming out within the month. So look out for that. Tell your friends about it. We are going to have a mediator. It'll be a little bit like some of the shows you've seen on some of the sports talk radio shows, where they have two completely different views, and then some woman or whatever is going to be in between breaking up the action, because it could get heated. So look out for that. But the Pelon and Chubby show is who's here right now, and that's what's going on. The same old show that we have. The two original, Chubby's here, Guy Murray, and then Pelon, Rick Salas, I am here. We're going to be here probably until, about 7:30, or until we interview the comics, and then we're going to check out the show.
Right, so, it's going to be looking live.
What time we got right now?
Got a crowd. It's 7:20.
7:20.
We've been doing this about a half an
another,
hour.
15 minutes.
If we can't get another interview, or maybe get a comic up here. We're going to go and then just walk the crowd and do it right. I mean, there's people outside eating barbecue. People coming inside just chilling. Yeah. I'm going to do a spin around real quick.
It looks good. They got a big old trailer, huh?
Hey, yes. I'm going to get some pulled pork myself. I had to go.
That's no joke.
I'm pulled pork, some pulled pork nachos.
Hey, you think they got like good potato salad and
maybe some greens? Got some peach cobbler, I'm sure.
But no, what about red beans and rice?
Nah, no red beans and rice, man.
They got smothered steak. At least cornbread.
Come on, man. That's a barbecue truck, dude.
No, they should have cornbread on a barbecue truck, though. What? Hey, Flint's Barbecue up in Oakland, Everett and Jones, all them. They always had cornbread.
Right.
And okay. A great potato salad.
Okay.
And then some sliced beef and some ribs. And
I'm getting hungry, dude. Stop that. Links. Stop that. You're killing me.
That's what I'm talking about. That's good eating right there.
Look at these people, man. They just flooding the door. There's more people coming in
coming in right now. You know, the white folks went out there, looked at the barbecue, and turned right around.
Actually, this one lady was looking for something vegan. Lord have mercy. Stop me now.
Yeah, if it breathes, they ain't eating it. they don't eat this late.
They
eat like one meal a day. It's a half a meal. They share it.
And yeah. God damn, them barbecue nachos, that's my jam.
A lot of people are new to us. They don't necessarily understand. They don't necessarily understand our humor. But we talk trash about every different race. So don't feel special like we get on white people, picking on white people right now. I'm 100% Latino. If you haven't noticed, guy's black.
I might just be a little
dark. We talk shit about everybody equally. So tonight is the night where we're going to talk about the minority. And the minority so far looks like white folks.
For once,
we're going to talk about the minority.
And this is their land. This land is your land. Yeah. This land is my land.
Well, hey, Temecula is.
Temecula. Okay, Murrietta? Well, come on. From California to the New York skyline. This land was made for you and me.
I don't know if they pushed some folks to the outskirts or not.
Wasn't built for them, though. It was made for them, but it definitely wasn't built to keep them, those colonizers.
Hey, the one thing I did notice in there, though.
What's that?
Because it's a gym and everything. The acoustics.
And oh.
Bro, they're going to have a challenge tonight because it is going to echo like a motherfucker.
It feels like a night. It feels like a high school dance. Just coming out for a high school dance. Those old Sadie Hawkins or something.
Hey, I'll tell you what. If they were to hire these people for, like, nightclubs and shit, they wouldn't have no shootings because we came through the door.
We came right
up. And they were on us like TSA.
Hell yeah.
They were, like, frisking us. They're like, who in the fuck are you?
Until we got like,
hey, isn't this a youth athletic group?
Then we got
like,
official.
Who the fuck are you?
They checking it out. They're making sure it's a safe environment.
They're no joke. There's like no free drinks. Dude, I barely got you the designated driver free Coke.
Just got one DD free drink?
And they had a hard time with that. They were giving me the like, I don't know about that. Luckily, it's a law.
Yeah, they got to have a DD free drink.
So that's kind of funny. We're a little reluctant. I had to pay for my beers. We're doing this for free. But you know what? It's going to a good cause, man. It's going to kids.
It's going out for
children. Having to pay for my drinks when it's like a fundraiser type show. I'm all for that. It's all good. I always love the protective grandparents.
Yeah.
You know? Like when they bring the halfway decent looking kid. And they're not even that good looking, but you know what I mean?
I don't think that's the grandparents. I think that's the parents.
No.
There's a gap there. There's an age gap there.
But they're like you're scoping out on there. You know, there's none of that going on tonight, folks. You can chillax. You can be rest assured that we are married.
we got priors.
And we're old and.
We're dressed down, so you can't.
We have no more drive.
Yeah, we
our only drive is producing a good show.
That's what we do.
That takes everything out of us.
That's what we're motivated to do.
And the plumbing doesn't work anymore.
Hey, speak for yourself. Speak for yourself,
you're
brother.
You're in no danger.
Speak
no danger
for yourself,
of,
brother.
Anything happening. Plus, there's no interest here.
So, 7:25 now, and it's getting closer.
We're still trying to get a comic. I don't know what's going on.
This is crazy.
Text Valentine. If you guys don't mind just hanging out.
Hang out for a little bit.
If you got something better to do, then by all means, get out there and do it.
I've seen her at a couple of the shows.
if you want to hang out and just watch your board, just chill out, watch us. I am going to try and get a hold
people
of
people got
Valentine.
A little jiggy, little stepping.
Huh?
Alpha Phi Alpha right there. A little fraternity. He even step master right. He probably too old. He can't step, though. He probably can't step anymore if he had to do an API.
I went to college. I wasn't a big fan of
the step show and the fraternities. No.
Not so much. Especially the military ones.
Right on.
Not so much.
Again, we're at the Intensity Athletics building in Murrietta at 38444 Sky Canyon Drive, Suite 140 in Murrietta. We're right above the business park, and it's...
Hey, if anybody has any questions, by all means, text in, message on
there, our Pelon and Chubby regular lines.
Questions you might have about the show, anything you want to talk to us about.
Anything.
Anything you want us to address.
About, we'll go undress if you have to.
Yeah.
Getting all close and personal.
What's going on?
Nothing, I was just saying. So, what's up? Getting close and personal.
We got, we're just waiting to see what's going on here, but... anything, whatever. Well, we got a little downtime. We're supposed to get Cory and Chad, maybe.
Maybe.
On here to say what's up.
Esther or one of the comics.
Or even Esther, if she shows up.
But we got it. We got to shut it down. And
none of the comics seem to be here yet, which is
funny.
That's
typical.
Interesting, because the show's supposed to start at 7:30, right?
Man, it didn't start on time.
What?
Yeah.
Doors open at 6. Show's supposed to start at 7:30.
People still congregate.
And not a comic in sight.
Congregating.
The only comics that are here are right here at the table.
But, no, don't make me go here. Grab that microphone.
We're here in case of a pinch. But because of the short notice, I can tell you right now it's going to cost you. But we will absolutely step in a pinch.
I ain't scared
to
grab a mic.
Do a good show.
For real.
But just know that it's going to cost you.
It's going to get ding, 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 ding. So, Michael, I want to thank you for hanging with me.
I see Valentine out there in the red and black.
You can't miss that, brother, in that jacket now. That jacket. You can't miss the jacket. He's darker than pitch. But that jacket, you got
all I see is a red jacket.
That's it. Up. He had the audacity to put black under it. He darker than me. And he out there in a red jacket.
Hey, it's almost like the headless horseman.
Yes.
This is just training. the red jacket running through Murrietta.
I get it.
Oh, you can't. That's all you see is the jacket going. Wow. Like they needed to turn the music up, really. And then somebody smoking weed.
You got that? Did you get that, too?
Yeah.
You got that, too.
Hey, you know what, man?
It's a party, yo.
There's nowhere that is exempt
it's
from
a party, yo.
Smoking weed, right?
It's a party.
It's legal now. It's recreational now. People can just light up or do whatever, wherever.
Whenever, wherever, why ever. However, you know. Whenever, do ever. Oh, my God.
So, I don't know. Hopefully, they come. Man, that music got kicked up. Like
it did. More people showed up, and then it's like... The volume went up.
Yeah,
it's
like you can't hear it. Like nobody's worried about the hearing of these.
Speech impediment.
Hey, so you know what? Once we break this down, though, we're not. I mean, we could take a break, but I don't know if anybody's going to tune back in.
It's up to them. It's up to us.
You know?
I'm definitely going to hit that damn truck, though. Hopefully he runs out of food before I get there, because that'll just keep me from getting it. I'm thinking about, not going to the truck, although I'd like to go to that truck. But I hope he runs out of food before I get there.
Oh, a barbecue?
Yeah.
Is there a long line?
There's a long line. Hope he runs out of food.
I'm straight. God. I'm going to be like the little white chicks and not just eat.
Eat a lettuce leaf and shit.
Don't eat nothing.
Stay back.
No unnecessary
push back
carbs.
Just a little bit.
Right. So, this is the Pelon and Chubby Show special edition coming to you from Murrietta. We are at the Valentine LOL Crew fundraiser for Intensity Athletics. we're sending the cheer group to Hawaii. Aloha, mahalo, and all that good stuff.
Whatever.
So they're going out there. They're going to spread cheer across the rainbow country. And I wonder if Hawaii is at all upset about the rainbow being taken over. Because they had a firm grip on that rainbow for years and years. And the rainbow state, you know, are they up in arms about it being taken over by a whole different community?
I don't
know.
That'd
be a good question to ask.
Yeah, that's a good question.
Anybody's from Hawaii.
Hey, Rick.
Yo.
All
right, bring him up.
So we're about to get a
I mean,
get
we could go back there, but... Hey, we're going to need one more chair.
Okay.
Or you want to? What do you want to do? Bring them both? Hey, I'm going to put one right here. That's right. So, allegedly, we have Chad and Cory coming over here. So, I don't want to take up a whole lot of their time, but they're going to be coming over in a minute to get down, do their thing. Hey, turn it a little bit so we can get more of that. Just give it a little turn. Other way, that way. You don't have to go back so much. We don't need so much. There we go, right there. We don't need so much of the door. So, Cory and Chad, the Smash Brothers, are going to be coming over in a minute. Valentine went back to get them. They're going to be coming out and talking to you. We're going to do a little interview. I don't know how much of an interview it's going to be because it's loud. So... It's going to be tough to hear. It is important that you have music wherever you go. There was hardly any people here, but they need music. Nobody wants to do anything without music. So I don't know. It's one of those things. It could be like an ethnic thing, but I'm just saying. I don't know how important it is to have this much music this early, this loud. But I'm here for the cause. So whatever they want to do, we're good with. But, you know, it is what it is. Guy's over there trying to... Guy is having a dual role tonight as the producer of the show and as the member of the show. But he has to try and coordinate these interviews and set up and stuff. So he's doing the yeoman work tonight.
Yeoman?
Yeah.
Yeoman?
Yeah, so... That's what it takes sometimes. You go out on the road. You never know what's going to happen. You never know the situation.
It's live.
You just got to kind of adapt to it. And, you know, things happen. That's the way it is. So, everybody get your cocktail.
Get your cocktails. Oh, man, I need a refill.
If you're at the house, what's up to Jay the Holy Roller?
Jay,
member of the Pelon and Chubby Show.
Ica.
Yeah, we'll see what's up. But guy's at home in here. This is his shit right here. But like I said, we are hoping that guy's going to be able to come through. Or Valentine's going to come through and get this interview going.
So we got people's in,
we'll
the, house,
what
people
happens,
in the house.
Man. But guys,
that was
Ica. Here's people got people. Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa.
Whoa.
Here's people got people.
My people got people.
And those people got people. Is that Esther?
Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah.
Tell her to come over here.
What's up, girlfriend? Hey, sit down for a second. Sit down for a second.
Let me just check in with Sigmund.
Okay.
He's coming here in a minute.
Yeah.
All right. So let me give the proper introduction here. I think L.A. or Hollywood's the home.
What's up?
Where are you coming from tonight?
From L.A.
All right, all the way from L.A., coming down here with the Valentine and LOL crew coming to rock the house, all for a good cause here at Intensity Athletics. Put your hands together, make some noise. Welcome to the Pelon and Chubby Show, Esther Ku.
Yo, can they hear us with all this music in the back?
Yeah, they got
it. Plus,
got
noise canceling.
Wow.
Hey,
plus,
we got the highest.
Highest
high
level microphone.
Yes.
Right here, this is going to pick up all your Facebook Live. So you're on right here on Facebook Live. Also, right there is the website for Intensity Athletics. So you're here tonight. You're going to be featuring tonight.
Yes, I am.
Absolutely cool. You are you have a ton of credits. You're up and down LA, all across the country. I know it's hard to do an interview like this because
she's
of
cold.
The noise and everything. But,
is this show outdoors?
No, you're in here. But we couldn't.
I require a heater.
Yeah, we couldn't handle all the noise. We'll make it quick. But so how long you been doing comedy, and what got you started, and who do you love, and why do you do this thing? Why do you love making people laugh?
I'm like Snoop Dogg when he got his star walk of fame on the sidewalk. I love me.
That's what it's all about. Hey,
who's your favorite comedian? Me.
Yeah,
motherfucker.
Love, you gotta love you in order to make everybody else laugh.
Yeah.
Why do you like making people laugh? What do you get out of it?
I like making people laugh because I have issues.
I got issues.
And it helps me never really get to know you by just joking about you.
I'm joking about you. I'm busting
you. You know, Uncle Philip, you know what I'm talking about?
I know what
I'm talking about. So what kind of things do you talk about? Life experiences?
Well, you're trying to get a preview of what's going
to
happen on the show?
Let the people know what they're missing. They still have a chance to get down here. The show hasn't started yet.
Get your lazy ass down here while you watch it live when
it's
you could
Saturday
be here.
Night. Come on out. Yeah. Check out. This is Esther Ku. She's going to be tearing it up tonight. So what can people expect other than super funny?
I like to rip on people.
Nice.
Right. Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, because I
or like just jokes.
No, just like the way you look.
Oh, nice. Right. So hey, if you're looking like funny style out there, Esther's gonna rip you up. She's gonna tell you all about yourself. She's gonna tell you why you're not with somebody if you're single.
Well, because you know, looks are all we have to go on when you first meet somebody. At a comedy show when you're sitting in the audience. So it's just fun to pick someone apart.
That's right. That's what it's all about. Getting out here and making people laugh, having some fun. We are looking forward to seeing you perform tonight. Thank you for coming out.
Thanks so much.
The kids appreciate it. Valentine, the LOL crew, put together a great show, and she's going to get out there and rip it out. Come down if you haven't had time to get a ticket. Still tickets available out the door, some super barbecue outside. We're going to let her get warm and get inside. Thank you, Esther, for joining us.
Thanks so much for having me.
Thank you. Hey, take it out.
So Chad and Cory are coming in a minute. They're going to do their little bit and tell you about everything. Esther's going to go warm up inside, and the show's going to start soon. Here's how you know you're at a comedy show and it's just about to get started. The line for alcohol is out the door. You know, people got to get their swerve on. Get your swerve on here. Don't do it on the road, please.
Oh, my God, it's Brittany.
But, hey, Esther just did her.
Uh-huh.
Esther was just on.
Okay. We got 40 chat right here. All right,
cool.
What's up, guys?
What's up, guys? I got two chairs right here.
Robert B. Fowler.
All right, hey, coming to the Pelon and Chubby Show. The headliners of the Valentine LOL Crew fundraiser for Intensity. All right, perfect. Okay, after them we'll go. All right, so we got your headliners tonight, the Smash Brothers, Chad and Cory. What's going on, fellas? How are we doing tonight?
Oh, we're doing good. We're actually fucking cold.
Yeah, it's cold. We're
tropical, man. We're out here fucking freezing, actually, to be honest with you.
We're out here because the DJ was ripping it up in there. There was one person, but he had it on like 12.
As soon as when we walked in, I thought I was in Las Vegas. I was like, God damn, where are we?
So how you been? What's up? Last time I seen you guys was at Rookies in Oceanside.
Oh, wow. Yeah. Yeah, man, we haven't done gigs like that in a long time, thank God. But, yeah, thank we're God. Good, man. Oh, look, there's a Mason brother. We're Masons, too.
Nice.
Look at that. All the Illuminati's here. Yeah, listen, we're just glad to be here, man. You know, when he hit us up, we've done work for Valentine before, and then we run into you. I mean, this is pretty damn cool. You got a food truck out here. We've been here, like, 2 minutes.
There's more white women here than I thought there would be.
Hey, yo, it's Murrietta, baby.
Yeah.
There's more white women. I'm surprised about that.
You know, we started doing some jokes earlier, and we started talking about let's talk about the minorities. And I told
you mean,
guys,
you mean us?
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, we're the fucking goddamn minority. Shit's changed now.
So what you guys been up to? You out here doing a good cause? You doing this to send the girls to Hawaii? Some of the guys, too, for the cheer, competitive cheer?
Yeah, listen, we've performed in 48 states. One state we never performed in is Hawaii, so you know we're getting Jesus points for putting kids to Hawaii.
Amen, Chad. Preach on it, Chad. We haven't done Alaska and Hawaii. We've done all 48 states, 7, 8, 9 times each state. But we've never been to Hawaii, so good. We're putting some kids on the island, and we can't even go to the fucking island.
If you can't get there, at least send them there.
Amen, yeah. Maybe they can steal us some macadamia nuts and bring them back to us and shit.
Yeah, so, hey, what else you guys been up to? Like, what's been going on?
The past 10 months, we've been actually not touring as hard this year. We tried to take some time off. The past 7 years, we burned and burned. I mean, my brother and I both went through personal shit in our lives, and we just needed to take, not time off completely, but instead of doing 350 shows a year, we've only did about 150 this year.
Still getting out there, though. But everybody's doing good now? You got
we're doing good. Refresh, charged up, and 2019, we're already booked out. We're ready to travel the nation and do this shit.
That's what's up.
That's good to hear, man. I hear you on that, though. I went through a little rough patch like that. Had to clean up, and now we're back out here hitting it hard. Got the podcast thing going, and that's great. I'm looking forward to seeing you guys. If you guys haven't seen Chad and Cory the Smash Brothers ever, put your seatbelts on because it's about to get fucking wild up in here. This is not a kid's show. We're out here. It's just grown folks getting down.
That's right. If you're easily offended, then you fucked up. Thanks for your money. Beat it. Hit the fucking door.
There's the door.
Hey, and it's not too late. If you're sitting on your couch, you're somewhere, Murrietta, Temecula, you want to get out.
Got
to
get in the house.
Do something, have a little fun. Come out here. Check out the show. It's going to a good cause. Plus, you're going to see an incredible comedy show. There's barbecue out there, alcohol. Come buy a ticket, support a good cause, and see these two talk some shit and give you some funny. There's no better cure than laughter.
Amen to that.
And they'll, maybe they'll give you a little touch or something, give us one something that they can that you can see what you're missing, fuckers. Get off the couch and get down here. Give us a little something. I don't know. Say, give them something.
Fuck with them.
What do you got, Chad? Nothing. We brought condoms. That's it.
All right. We're ready then. They're ready. They're back in the stack. Strapped and ready to go.
So you brought condoms. Are we looking for any kind of specific?
Listen, here's what it boiled down to. It was a two-joint drive to get here, and that's how long it took us to get here. We're here. We're relaxed. We're ready to party. There's good-looking ladies.
Yeah. 20 minutes?
No, that was
me an hour.
It was a 60-minute drive. We do good joints. Where
slow burn, baby.
One joint sits you down.
Those
I don't
those
care.
Are blunts, right?
Yeah, no, we don't.
We don't fucking blunts.
Yeah, no tobacco at all. We just fuck with straight old school reefer.
There you go. What is your favorite strain? You have one favorite? Maybe?
No, we're the opposite. One of us likes indica. One of us likes sativa. But listen, the weed's gotten better nowadays. I mean, now you can go to a fucking dispensary and you can get anything you want, and it's more powerful than you think. It'll sit you down.
Into the edibles at all?
No, hell no.
Nah.
That's too much couch lock. That's 8 hours of...
We don't even do the vapor shit. We don't do hash.
Old school joints.
We just smoke joints, son. That's it.
Use a rolling machine?
Hell no.
By hand.
We roll one-handed so we can drive with the other.
Amen, Chad. You heard it.
That's it. Hey, so this is the Smash Brothers, Chad and Cory, breaking it down. They're going to get some drinks. They're going to get prepared for the show. We don't want to hold them up too much, but we appreciate them being here. We appreciate them stopping on the Pelon and Chubby show and saying what's up.
No problem, man.
Good to see you.
Thanks for having us, guys.
Thanks for having us.
We'll be out there
watching. We'll see you on the watch, man.
All right.
If you get a chance, hit us up on the...
All right, brother, we will.
That was Chad and Cory. That's what we were waiting for.
That was on point. I like that.
Yeah, so...
Esther Ku didn't disappoint either, so she's fucking cold. She's going to get warm. And
this isn't the ideal, shit that I like. And you know me, I'm picky as fuck about the lighting. The camera shot looks like shit.
But hey...
The sound is horrible, but we're here. It's okay. We're here, like you said, for a good cause, guy.
Yes.
And we got to interview Valentine, which is important.
Yep.
The owner of Intensity. She was just here. She was just in right here. Okay. And so that will be the last interview. We're going to break this shit down and get ready for the show. But it was good.
Yeah, it was a good one. Good night tonight, and got to see some people.
Hey, we got some good video.
Really good. Not bad.
So we'll put that on the Pelon and Chubby site.
Jesus.
We got no new viewer. Which is
it's
fine,
okay.
Man.
It's okay.
It's Saturday night.
So it's a Saturday
fine.
Night.
It is. That's the way it goes. So,
so yeah, we're going to shut this down in about 5.
Yeah, no, we're just waiting on the owner.
Okay.
Of Intensity Athletics. She was just here. So, well, hey, at least it all came together.
It did. I mean,
I had my doubts at first. At least it's all kind of come together.
Yes.
Hey, so after we interview the owner, we will break it down and put it in the car.
Okay.
We'll see y'all Wednesday. Wednesday
see y'all
afternoon, we'll see y'all.
In the usual places, yeah. With the usual faces.
Yes, sir.
And then I want to thank you guys for stopping in on this particular live as a feed. As a jump ship came across my website, all my people, what's up, Joseph, Rodolfo, Joseph, Roberto, what's up, Sheila, Shepherd, I know you guys back east, freezing your little asses off, and y'all came out and checked and see what Pelon and Chubby's all about, doing a live on site.
She was here, where is she?
And we're doing it, they got me on the corner of the mic on the screen, but that's okay, we're doing it live.
You know what, she might be busy, bro. It's 7:47.
And they ain't started yet.
Hey, Val. I'm going to just break it down.
Okay. We shot it.
It's getting close.
Okay.
All right, so. Hey, so. No.
Yeah, just go straight in that door and go to the right.
So, yeah, we're going to wrap this one up. I want to thank you guys for coming out tonight. It's a hot spot in the real town tonight. Murrietta's on fire just because the LOL crew's in-house with Esther Ku, Robert B. Funny, and the Smash Brothers going to be putting it down. And this is what we do on spot, on location with Pelon and Chubby. Take them home.
So we are the Pelon and Chubby Show. We thank you for joining us again. This is the special edition on remote in Murrietta, California. We survived. It was battle pay, but we don't mind because it's for a good cause for the kids in Hawaii. On behalf of the Valentine and LOL crew, we are going to get ready for this excellent comedy show coming. And we thank all of you for tuning in on Facebook, tuning in on the website. All of you that are going to tune in later on, we appreciate it. Thank you very much for watching. As always, tune in on Wednesday, 6:30. Look out for the new show coming with Valentine and Rick Salas. Yeah, I said it. It'll be on within the month. Thank you all for tuning in. Until we meet again, until we see you at another event on Wednesday at 6:30, see ya!
Good night, everybody.